some poems about that. Yeah, I'm going to read mostly from this trilogy I did that sort of came to an unexpected halt during the pandemic. I was spending a lot of time with my friend, hero, Mark Lanegan, and we both had tours canceled. And we were trying to figure out a way to get some cash for us. But you haven't made a poetry book. I make them. Do you have any poems? I'll try. And I loved them. I thought they were great. He's such an incredible lyricist. And part of the reason I started publishing books by musicians is I often thought they didn't get the credit they deserved, these people who wrote. People sort of thought of them as only lyricists, but I thought there was so much poetry in what they were doing. I just wanted to provide an outlet for them. And him and I struck up an even deeper friendship, I guess, than we had. Sending each other poems back and forth all through the night. He left Los Angeles for Ireland, and we continued our friendship and writing relationship, and he passed shortly after. So we released plague poems while he was still with us, and he finished the last two books of the trilogy, Year Zero and Ghost Radio after. So I'm gonna read from those. A lot of them, I'm a slow writer with poems, so a lot of mine were playing catch up to him, so they're often referential to him. And also, my other friend, Genesis Pure, she passed away early 2020 also. This is called For Robert Bly. It's about, he's one of my favorite writers, and it's about a time when I woke him up from a nap, basically. I'm thinking of you, Robert, from this side of heaven, and thankful to have met in New York and Vermont. I once woke you from a nap to say, thank you, but I have to leave. Arlo Guthrie is annoying the fuck out of me. You understood where this young man stood, having slept in the train stations and fought against your own wars. Sometimes on the hunt for beauty, we sacrifice our own lives. I wish I could speak with you now on how talking has led me astray. Waking at 4 to be with the blackbird. A song is a way of crying without tears, and I'm trying not to drown, but the waves creep steadily upon my deserted shore. I buried my brother this week with Iron John by my side. The population of men has been broken in more than half. You are with him now, having all escaped apartment life in the city of death. Rumi, Kabir, Lorca, Hafez, Jimenez, Neruda. I know that people die, but the birds sing each dawn anyway. I am flying over the deep of the sea with my last good wing. Friends, tell me what to do, since I am drunk on the night and still in love with the setting stars. Only words are immortal. Don't leave me in the in-between. I have loved enough for a century of soldiers. Each poem is a battle in mortality's war of a once-forgotten resistance to extinction. Find this in the future and kiss me in the bunker. Don't leave me in the burning woods. I have touched the flame and gone back for more. Every scorched acre grows a new era of longing. How quickly we adjust to inhabitable weather. Set ablaze the night and hold me for warmth. Don't leave me in the everlasting tundra. I've seen darkness stretching over a globe of sorrow. Each morning I rise and thank the sun for the light. Each heart has a purpose. To harden, to soften, to bleed, to beat. I have now found mine inside the deep chamber of yours. Anatomy of melancholy. Melancholy is the royal road to God. That's why the lamb is in love with the wolf. the hillside stranglers with strong calf muscles. I dance in a mirror to hear come the warm jets. Grief is a doorway to heaven. The elephant mourns outside the lion's den. Fall asleep to the sound of car windows breaking and crawl out of bed to feed the garden. Downwards to darkness on the songbird's wings in vertical passion, bluer than the sky. You have given me hope and oblivion and at times a reason to live. For now, I'm on the other side of the world, grappling the elusive cliffs of love, with your voice in my head and your hand on my heart. I've had this reoccurring fear that those I get close to will disappear. I know that each day is a gift, but those days were invaluable and can't be returned. You turn on the light inside the cold fortress. It's since gone out. I wait here in the dark for reignition. Vigilante, NYC, 1988. The skinheads have taken Madonna hostage. Take the law into your own hands. The wake. We are mostly made of water. Eventually, all dams break. I'm floating on my back in the wake of your absence. When I start writing these, it just triggers sort of other relationships with people I've lost also with the similar hands. This is a poem about someone I used to play music with who passed away by accident. West Philly crime scene. Turntable, black dust matrix, glare of burning church. Somewhere in the sadness, embarrassed and so dumb. Two guns, one head, Lalette, three guitars, royal couch, Victorian, suicides, murder too. Voodoo doll, jumping pins, Fred Perry trash can, fetish fuck, World War, kill the secret pool. Dishwash, peat moss, black cloud, death ghost, flashlight, red spray, four walls falling cell. February, Philly, sickness spoon, shooting spree, tall boy hits the floor. Regent Street, haunted house, you can have it, don't look back. And another room. James over love. Richmond roommate hangs himself from a tree on the James. Over love, I guess, no one ever said. Hmm. 40 days. This is a poem from Mark, who is part of the eulogy that I wrote. It's always time, the slipping gift between the pre and post, and time to love and learn and hurt and heal, staring at the hummingbird, bathing in the lion's mouth. We risk it all for a moment of peace. Vampiric hands reaching through the aerial realm, dragging downwards, the soul saver and sinner together as one, through the cryptic sorrow of the world's unraveling, I need you, stay with me now. I wake up in the blackness of some new apocalypse and can't keep up with the names anymore. Siren shatter, gunshot scream, hurricane anyone, hollow point reserved for the intruder, I give it away, make a double coffee, look at toast, listen to country life, it's so very hard to lose a real life friend. Easter everywhere, and your seat is ready at the table in the kingdom of the clouds. Pearls and gold and painless and free. As the devil's grin mouths amazing grace, Jesus weeps, hold my hand in the paradise discotheque and sing. We used to say, there'd come the day, we'd all be making songs or finding better words. These ideas never lasted long. The black Phoebe lands at the cemetery lake, and I have no words now, just blank. Traffic spars the spirit, directionless and spinning. Cigarette lingers so slowly. Heaven, scorch earth, arson on the hillside, torch the rock and roll hall of flame. This is the final poem in our trilogy. I know you wouldn't want me to overthink it. Sometimes people break through with the way the book on the shelf appears in your hands. I don't want to close this chapter, and I don't want to finish this, and I don't want to say goodbye. Mm. Those are all from Ghost Radio. Disclaimer number one. I should have made my first poem in the second book with Mark better. There's so many reasons why I didn't do that. I tried so hard and tried it all. From Tylenol to Tramadol to Trileptal, Xanax and Topamax, with more rings than a nicer suit, ashwagandha and dragon fruit, just driving with dribble until the wheels wear out. At the end of the road with no tracks to bury, pollen, penicillin, imperialism, impotence. There are so many reasons why I didn't do that. But here it is, the first poem in the second book with Mark.
Hmm.
There is a cave at the bottom of the sea. I did not die or fall on Jesus. By the time the flood arrived, I just sank with the weight of the rock in my heart. Titanic, Krakatoa, Janesta, Wolf. I did descend, as stubborn as me, in a cave so deep at the bottom of the sea. Dracula. Your poem sucks. Here, have this one. Cascade. It's never just peace, you know. The bridge burns from both ends. About all that rain coming down, it's not heroic, just wet and distracting. And now you know why I spent so many years indoors wrapped in your arms. The dream was to outrun the avalanche, to enjoy the meadow at ease, before the sun went out, before the tar blackened the sanctuary. Like the swallow I fought to love, flown high and gone low, for and against nature, through storm and sea that always return to the nest of your love. Leave the garden gate open too long and the devil will come in. Then you will only grow a world with no flowers. Love can't keep living on this dirty soil. Without conviction, we will wilt. There is no beauty in the corroded, weeded soul of the savage, just ruins of the palace where once bloomed an empire. I have locked the garden gate. Just now, the devil is frustrated, but I don't want to live. Slouching towards Babylon. Sabotage meets me at the door of my dreams, holding Voltaire's Book of Fate in its calm, troubled hug, and I'm spiraling like water, drunk on itself, yet still dehydrated despite this all-consuming instinct. The problem is, I'm trying to overcome myself. I cannot love the one I love. You come in like a saint of everything, Aetna, ex the deity, eternal, etc. My mission was to drown in the waves, beneath the drink, and over it all. My intercession was to swim in your love, above the surface, and under God. Lanegan suggested meditation. He says, you just think of a positive thought and repeat it. I said, how do you think of a positive thought? Baby, I'm blue. I could have loved you in another life. My carcass was made of blue agave instead of red light. Evil. All hail the king of the underworld, who reigns upon cowards, posers, phony rock and rollers, with abscess and acid, access, comas and heart attacks, sex swings and handguns, the golden voice with the golden smile, from here and there and a little bit of everywhere. deep in the Bible, black hard resistance, towering over Los Angeles beyond, with peach Red Bull, Camel Crush, and tamarind candies. Stoned in the teenage winter, face down in the field, freedom rings in and out of hell and always answers my calls. You say, it feels like I died a horrible, painful death lasting years and no one noticed. Listen, old scratch, everyone noticed. They always do. It's just their frustration that kept them so quiet. Tucked away from the streets, they made their beds in safe houses all across your empire. Dead the living versus alive the dead. We laugh just knowing that we could burn the whole world if we wanted to. They say, live by the sword, die by the sword. We did not suffer, but beheaded so many fools. God paints a portrait as the devil of heaven, smiling with horns and cool in the flames, wearing a cross for a compass and the cosmos for rings. It's a strange religion where even death cannot outlive the king. Should I read some more?
Yeah.
I awoke from a dream at 5:23 because your voice was too clear, saying, oh, hello, you made it through after all. I'm surprised this thing actually worked. When the body drops, did they not embalm you so that your tongue could stay intact? But you know your voice will live on forever. I said, oh, hello to you too. You made it through after all. Nothing with you surprises me. Made a copy and started to read from the first book of the Bible. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth, the androgyne and the creation, the pandrogyne and creator. My dream, this life, my time, with you, it's as if from the beginning, you already knew. Never ending, March 17th, 2020. Burning death incense in the Nepalese censer you gifted me. From the home you shared with her, there's no sky anymore. Today is the day your bodies will sleep in the ground like the bed, in the land you shared with her, and there is no why anymore. Living together, loving forever, united allies. To play a show in New York with Cycle TV in 2019. Jim was in the hospital the day of, so the show had never happened. And I visited her prior to the show in the hospital. This is about when I walked in, there was someone trying to offer spiritual advice to them. And Jim just said, I'd rather have some candy. In Cornell, while horse pistol, William Street, downtown, floor 4C. You just asked the nurse, how about ketamine? I love John Lennon, but you prefer Paul. Misunderstood, experimental and all. You talk Janice and Jim and Kurt and Lou, and Jimmy and Brian and Ian and you. Speaking to God as a human, you say, the shaman will take years from your life. The bones so heavy and the heavens so far, the spirit so full. Camouflage for 2020. The softer the machine, the more naked the lunch. While under life, let's cut to the words. Have Brian and Bill found their third mind? How many more minutes to go? Tristan, Sara, beat me Dada, Ginsburg in India, or 12th and A. Painting with words and hoarding the dead. As wisdom passes through the touching of hands, the world is telling us to no longer touch. But we don't need hands to really get through. Shakespeare still dances inside dream machines. Vibrations are good, drifting through Arcadia from the 6660s through the infinite 20s. Tire damage. When you tire of the wreckage and the car crash of your heart, I will be there like a roadside mechanic who can repair anything except themselves. Locked outside the gates. Magic defends itself against the lifeless ghosts hell-bent on dethroning your crown. We walk through Queens for vodka and exercise, breasts out and spike in vain. I half smile at the sigh in the imaginary wake of your celebrated lives, all driven till the wheels turn to dust, while all the others only have one, only defined by you. Iron youth has rusted. I get such simple pleasure in little things these days, large ice cubes in a small crystal glass, and the way you fly from one room to the other, sing-shouting most of the words from a song you just heard. Looking through your letters, I feel a sense of uselessness, like all those books in the closed window of the bookstores. On how the future will be, blasted to irrelevance by way of plague, one or another, today's day is so close to the past that it was really just a matter of time. You ask, how are you handling this so well? It's just that I never expected anything else. Time fades like the lead stuck in your palm. I spent years staring at it, so much as I can still see it. Something that's no longer there. From a book called Deathbeds, which is sort of the first compendium I released ever of like tour journals and lyrics from my old band and some of the first poems I wrote that I published in 2007. 05, 09, 07. I feel as if I've been moving for a year, trudging boxes sewn both empty and flooding. I hope to thread the black hole with no strings attached. Tennessee said men like you get a wolfish look in their starved eye. I sneak some good in the reflection of those wearing sunglasses at night. Picking up skirts on bicycle seats, as children they warned us that our faces would get stuff like that. Sex is this training wheel, still peddled. I don't know why I keep my nose in the dead dirt, just because I stepped on a rake once, trying to smell the infinite fields of sunflowers. Fireworks redux. Fireworks out the window. Years later, I still feel nothing. Massachusetts. I thought we'd sink with the Mayflower of rock and roll, like the pilgrims that went down before. Fretless life. Cigarette lungs, young sex in the streets with the strum of a thousand drowning filthy guitars. Rigid hooker, desperate tongues, port body in the sheets with the salt of a trillion melting miserable miners. Crumpled grip, fiendish gloves. I thought we'd sink with the Mayflower of rock and roll like the pilgrims we worship before. April 2001. Subpar, by far, new order, your car. American hardcore. Count the bones broken here. Don't tell me our youth was wasted. Back then we destroyed everything that moved. You can see it in my face. It's true. What we felt then we feel now. What we predicted then is happening now. My heart is a buried capsule of incomparable fear. If this was a phase, then why do we walk aimlessly at midnight, outside on the hills to fill the holes inside. Remember me as you do the lightning, erratic, beautiful, but ultimately a flash. This is a poem called Death is Sad, which I wrote for my friend Sammy, who's from here, the legend. Let us celebrate it with our fangs out. Here's a 15-second video of my tear and a black handspring and a back handspring for my sorrow. And death is sad. The cash and the claws go hand in cold hand. Here is a yellow crying face and a red broken heart. Cartoons from the Jokers we are. Yellow for cowards, red for blood. I love Sammy. Stomping your faces on a West Coast curb. With beating heart and rolling eyes as the vultures of death pick at the scraps. Love is heavy, dead weight floats in the shallow wind, like the bait that needed but could not contain you. We've since learned to swim. It's true, a good man is hard to find, with the violent buried away. Intentions only get us so far from dull blades when the knife is your friend. In a town like this, you won't be forgotten, unlike those tending to you now, for the cry of the fire engine carries new pain. Echo Park is full of hot air. I want to thank you for the brotherhood, the imperfection of man. I knew where you stood, and I know where you stand. Pardon your ways in the middle of the tracks. This is called Locked Outside the Gates. Magic defends itself against the lifeless ghost hell-bent on dethroning your crown. Mile marker 23. This is from the first reader, volume one of the Heartworm Reader that I did, which featured 25 different poets doing 4 poems each. And about to begin compiling the second one, which should be out in April 22. Sympathy has taken you to me like a roadside flower, blown over by traffic, growing sideways into the street which drove me here in the first place. It's beautiful, but kind of fucked up. I was aching for you the way hypochondriacs manifest disease. People tend to find what they're looking for. Did you know you could love me forever? My ugliness was so sobering, and I spent so much money to see that clearly, so that you, whom I didn't know yet, would see some work in me. Maybe the point of all this is to remove all the rust to get back to who we were before there was any. Baudelaire's failed suicide note sold for 234,000 euros 2 years ago. I am writing one I don't mean now, about my failure of living all those years before 2012, before you even met me. You knew you could love me forever. LAWT. Baby, you are beautiful, walking with a mask on, as the ash of California's burning acres dance around my lung from the Hollywood reservoir. They bootleg the sun when no one's looking, and now I'm wondering why I live here, if not at all. You speed by me with a smile, and all grief gravitates to nothing, and you say, my love is as strong as the day is long. I felt no peak with you, so far from the American dream, that I mistook a lull in the war for actual peace. You took up residence inside your perfect prayer. Leonard Cohen wrote Hallelujah when he was 50 years old and winked at you when he was 80, 5 miles from here, 6 years ago today. I have been bathing on the roof of your marble arch ever since. That's a true story. We were at a grocery store, and then Leonard Cohen walked by and winked at Amy. So I thought I had liberty to go talk to him after that. The cereal aisle. And I'm going to end with a poem written by Mark Lanegan. It's brief. I just love it so much. It's just called Dark. Oil the machine and manifest upwards. Thank you so much.